Hi, I'm Mayor Jim Fiorentini. Welcome to Hayville. I'm here to tell you about the Mayor's Art Challenge and about how the creative economy is alive and well here in Hayville. Come join me on a tour. The Hayville Renaissance started here in the Hayville Lofts building. This long abandoned shoe factory with its high cathedral ceilings, its big majestic windows with a beautiful view of downtown, was perfect for artists. And in 2004, we rezoned this building for artist lofts and made a concerted effort to bring artists to our downtown area. We have one of those artists who's lived here for 3 years with us today, and I'd like to introduce you to her. Ariana, how are you?
I'm fine, how are you?
And what's your name?
My name is Ariana St. John.
And I understand you've lived here for 3 years.
I have.
And you've lived in one of the Beacon buildings.
I have, and I've really loved it. It's wonderful.
Wonderful. Are there other artists in the building?
There are, and they seem to like it just as well as I have.
And is this a good setting downtown for artists?
I think it's a wonderful setting for artists.
You go downtown sometimes
to
some of the restaurants and some of the places downtown?
I do.
Well, wonderful. Well, welcome to our great city and to downtown, and we're glad you enjoy it
here.
Thank you very much.
Okay.
The first big developer to come downtown was Beacon Companies of Boston, one of the largest residential developers in Massachusetts. They took this abandoned series of shoe shops, formerly known as Fifth Avenue Shoe, and remade it into the Court Event at Hayville Station. Today, that $30 million development houses a number of artists who frequent our downtown area. Here in Hayville, the creative economy works. Even in the worst recession in 70 years, the artists who came downtown helped to support the Wingate Street Arts District, art studios, framing shops, restaurants. They helped create public art and murals on some of the buildings down here. They helped create what we call the Hayville Renaissance. The creative economy works here at the Wingate Street Arts District, and we're here with Hamka Lawrence, who owns Angles and Art in downtown Hayville. How's it going?
Very well, Jim.
And do you meet people from the new buildings? Do they come in here?
We have quite a few people coming in from the new buildings in the area.
Wonderful. What have they done for your business?
They love to come in and stroll around, and they bring us work to take care of for their new apartments, and they enjoy what we have here.
So would you say the creative economy,
yes.
The theory is you bring artists to your downtown and they help the downtown. Is it working for you?
Yes, it's absolutely working for me.
Wonderful. You got a beautiful store here in the heart of the Wingate Street Arts District, and we wish you all the best.
Thank you very much.
The artists who have come to our downtown have worked with private groups like Team Hayville to sponsor public art projects all around the downtown. Murals like these on various buildings around the downtown area have helped beautify our city. Today, Hayville's known for its restaurants, its artwork, and its food service industries. But Hayville was once the woman's shoe slipper capital of the world. And this beautiful old shoe project, done by Team Hayville and by artists throughout the city, helped bring visitors to our downtown and help keep the creative economy moving. Artists and artwork brought people to our downtown, and people brought with them restaurants. And today, downtown Hayville, thanks in part to the artists and the creative economy, downtown Hayville has one of the most thriving restaurant districts in the country. Yahoo.com Realty called Hayville's restaurant district a district that can rival those even of capital cities throughout the country. Bringing public art and artists to our downtown has been critical to keeping our creative economy here in Hayville moving. We encourage artists to come down here on our brand new boardwalk. We encourage public art in the downtown and throughout our city. Today, school children from throughout the city help to create the murals that decorate our downtown and decorate some of our school buildings. Today, artists have created and maintained modern artwork here in the downtown and public art in public places, like John Greenleaf Whittier's birthplace, the Buttonwoods Museum, and one of our treasures, Winnikinny Castle. Today, the creative economy is alive and well here in Hayville. Thank you for listening.